Hi friends, I'm Dave Barkalow, pastor at Fort Walton Beach First United Methodist. Welcome to the Pastor's Study, our daily devotional that helps us focus our mind on the things of God. We're going through the Epistle of James together. We are in chapter 2, and we're in the middle of James's discussion of faith and works. Some want to say faith versus works, but that's really not what he's talking about. He's talking about the relationship between faith and works. That when we have true faith, it cannot help but to shine out through our works. And in this argument that he's having, he provides us two biblical examples to look at. So I'd like to read to you from chapter 2, verse 21 through 26. Was not our ancestor Abraham justified by works when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that faith was active along with his works, and faith was brought into completion by the works. Thus the scripture was fulfilled that says, Abraham believed God and was reckoned to him as righteousness, and he was called friend of God. You see that a person is justified by works, not by faith alone. Likewise, was Rahab the prostitute also justified by works when she welcomed the messengers and sent them out by another road? For just as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is also dead. Here James provides two biblical examples of people who believed something, who gave mental assent to something, but then who backed it up with their actions. Abraham, the father of all the Israelite people, the beginning of this promise to bring the Messiah into the world, he believed in God. But not only did he give mental assent to God, but he put his works behind him. He left his home. He left his father's house. He followed God to a land that he did not know. Ultimately, he was called on to sacrifice his own son, and he goes, and God stops him, but yet Abraham so believes in this God, has so much faith in this God, that he is moved to action even when he thinks that God's going to have to bring his son back from the dead. So his actions display his faith, and once that is displayed, then it is credited to him as righteousness. Then James makes a very interesting turn where he points out that the foreigner, Rahab, who hid spies, was the Israelite army, was coming into the promised land. They sent out spies. And in Jericho, it became known that there were spies in the city, and this woman hid Hebrew spies. And because of that, her whole family was saved. So she believed that this God that the Hebrews were following, that was the true God. But she didn't just believe it in such a way where she said, hey, yeah, I believe your God's the real God. Go face the authorities. No, she backed it up with what she believed. I love this closing line, verse 26. For just as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. So we are called to not just believe something with our heads, but to do something with our hands. Friends, remember, I love you. Take care of yourselves. And today, let's do something with our hands and shine the light of Christ.